Good. Were you on that giant wreck? Yeah, it's insane. I had like 5 clients call. Oh shit. Hold on. Technical difficulties. Hold on. Let's see, new. What happened to Mitch? Mitch? Hey, Mitch, you can't see us or what? Why don't you exit out and come back? And if you guys could slow down up front so we can tackle this together. Well, I just added everyone from both teams last minute. How you doing, Jay? Here. Chris, remind me where you are in the world right now. Britain? Brisbane! Okay. A little bit different. Okay, I see Mitch 4 seconds ahead. Okay, you guys are all ahead of me. I see weird times. Slow down for your beacon. You guys never been in a group ride? So... can you guys hear me? Okay. So, well, I wish Jay was here too. So this is, the second to last race of the season? I believe it is, and then I believe the last one is the time trial. And, I watched the premiere, just parts of it, of the climbs and stuff. It's kind of brutal. They were talking about, remember the last race of last season, Steve? Yeah, they were saying exactly that. They were saying that shit was brutal, and it's not quite that terrible because I know what I wanted to do. One of the reasons I wanted to get you guys to stop. I want to change my bike to the Scott Attic with the EBE. It's truly the best bike for this course, which is weird. The Scott Attic. And then if, there's different strategies. If you want, like, so I think the DT Swiss 62 is a good choice. Or the 8.9s. If you want to win a climb, you could even go Roval Alpinist. I'm going DT Swiss. But for some reason no one's riding them. The star ratings don't sync up with the real time testing. Yeah, but for whatever reason, the Scott Addict, I was reading about it. The Scott Addict with the Roval Alpinist is a slightly better bike than even the Tron on rolling courses. Yeah? You're saying no? Oh, yeah, I don't know about the gravel effects. It's just the course as a whole. Yeah. The Grail versus the Tron. And then, do you remember the KOM best time? I do. By Harding. Do you remember what it was? 6 flat. Yeah, and then you know what it was on the second lap? 7. So this is not where if you do the course Force Recon, this is not where you start. Which is unfortunate. So when you do the Force Recon, you start about maybe 2.5K from the rooftop climb in Neokyo. And so you got about 1K of flat, and then 1.5K of a gradual, like 2% up the railway, and then there's no power ups. So there's no power up until you hit the top, you get a power up, and then the only other power up is right after that, after the descent, they give you, you go through some arch, they give you one power up, and then other than that, it's just the peak of every climb. So when I did the recon, I did it all the way to the temple ascent. So there might be something after that. Someone just joined, is that Jay? Hey, good man. So yeah, we were just talking, this is not where like the Force Recon launches you from. It launched. Did you do it? Oh, nice. What are you writing? Are you? Yeah, they're crazy. Are you doing the addict? The Scott addict? Yeah. No, but I read Outside is West Insider too. That even beyond the Premier League, so they have a chart, the Scott addict with the Alpinist or like the DT Swiss is a faster, especially with the graph, faster climbing and rolling. Yeah. Yeah, so I might do the Alpinist, and I can assure you guys that anyone with a Tron is just gonna get decimated. At least. So this is half the castle climb. This is kind of lame. So we're skipping half the castle climb right now. We're halfway up the castle climb, which is kind of stupid. So. No, it started, I don't know why, remember on the recon, this is about 45 seconds in. On the recon the other day, I hit it at about 400 watts, which is 4 flat for me. Which... I think... So, like, the temple gives the most points, even more than finishing first overall. It's like 60 points. Yeah, but that's not my type of climb. This is my type of climb. So this is the only one I'm gonna go for fastest time. And if I have gas, I'm gonna try and get top 20. I think everyone just needs to like realize they need to pick their target, right? Like, I don't know what that is for you, Jay. So, yeah. No, I think I'm gonna blow them out on this. Like, so, and then I'm thinking about the teams, right, at stages in WTRL, right, that are 1 and 1 point behind us. WTRL is a conservation team, and there's not a lot to draft, right? So, it's going to be Perkins, it's going to be the Perkins show. I guarantee you Perkins is going to go for the temple. I really hope like a fifth place team wins. Yeah, because I don't think we're going to win. I don't know. Well, does anyone feel like making a move for rooftop? Definitely not FAL though. This is not familiar to Course Recon. Oh, well, I clicked the same route as the course. Oh, here, Castle KOM, it says starting right up. And No, Castle KOM is the middle. So, no data because it was not completed. So now it should lead us into temple. So, yeah. So we start in the city. We hit the rooftop. I think if Mitch and Camille, Mitch, you're with us this week, right? You're with us this week, right? I wish you were there last week. Hey, I just skied yesterday and drove back 3 hours and then rode a Honda. Yeah, that's my typical strategy, but this one is just so different. That's all they were saying during the premiere. It's like, so like the points for FTS on Castle, I think is 50. So if that's all the points I get, you know, like, that's huge points. And then it goes to 45, 35, and then like 15, you know? So it's enormous. So like you get almost like, you could almost fight for just the castle and then cruise the last place and do more for your team than getting in fourth place. Interesting after temple. I was watching, I don't know if we have the same power-ups to change it for us like they typically do from here. But they had the steamroller. Super good. And one of the guys used it, there's maybe like a 40 meter section of dirt. 3 kilometers from the end of the race, and it only lasts about 8 seconds, but he used it over it and it gained him like 4 seconds. He got overtaken eventually, but it's pretty well played because he had nowhere else to use it. Yeah, I'm always up for Discord. I can't shut up. I talk until my pulse is at 170 plus. Dude, I was just on the giant motivational ride, and I was like 18 seconds behind them, like pulling five watts per kilogram for at least 12, 13 minutes, and I had to act extremely calm on a phone call, three different phone calls, as I'm chasing them. It was probably the hardest workout I've had all week. So who else? Yeah. Well, so Perkins told me that Kelly, who's their other really good racer, and I think a good climber, had COVID, and one other guy. Stages, I have no idea. What I think is that the team that won the New York race, it was like, I forget, you know, that gray camo. It looked like they had some good climbers. So it's us three, and then who else? No, for just the team. Jacob's gonna fall. I mean, there's no shade on Jacob, but I've ridden with him enough to know that he gets burnt on spiky efforts. Yeah. Yeah. And then who else? Camille, right? Camille, who can surprise you, you know? He did a 3.8 on our time trial. Oh, he did put in a sub 50 minute L. What? Get out of here. Well, shit. I forgot, he's like, Shit, maybe we should like escort him into, see, well, that's the thing. The lead into the rooftop KOM is gonna be so chaotic. What? Just the, you know, like, the takeoff into the rooftop KOM is gonna be so chaotic. I don't even think we can place someone properly. But if he can get over, so like, what about this? Like, what if you were to take, Steve, you tell me, take the rooftop and castle just at a 2.0, right? And then just blast the temple and finish at an hour and 20 minutes. Is that workable? Is that, so the climb's coming, so it's rooftop KOM, and that's about 3 minutes in. Then you've got about a minute and a half descent, and 5 minutes of flatland until you start the castle KOM, which I told you I'll hit in about four. And then this is the segment between the castle and the temple, right here. Temple starts. Yeah. So that little section is considered flat. I'm in. We're going. Okay. Yeah, as I recall, you got a top 10 temple climb last time, didn't you? Yeah. I'll let you go. Thanks for joining. Talk us a try. I would just love to win a season, so I'm like taking it seriously. You know? It's great to be like, hey guys, we got third place, but like, can you imagine just winning a season? It'd be such a good feeling. Yeah, we're two races away. Yeah. So we are. Okay, see you, Jeff. Alright, you're up. Alright, Nick. So we are going backwards. It's okay. It's fine. I kind of wanted to talk with Jay and Mitch. So. Yeah. I mean, I've been so busy with shit that, like, I just, my only time to talk is while I'm writing, or, like, multitasking, but, yeah, I just wanted to stress that, like, going for the whole thing, you know, like, just, steady state is not a good strategy. Oh, I know, dude. I would love it to be that way. Believe me, that's my bread and butter. I think that's all three of us. This is bread. Well, Steve, you've got some other skill sets, but I mean, I keep on asking. I would love to ride with like one of those premier cheesecake teams for a team time trial, because I know I can hang with them. But. They never give me a slot. It's like the Euro crew, AHDR, that don't even know we have an American version. Yeah, that's pretty much how it works. Yeah, I didn't know how to like join a team. I kind of wanted to for a while. Like I was like, how do you join Arrow? Like how do I become a part of this? And you know, Nick walked me through it. Well, so I think, yeah, so, I don't know, how does that work, Steve? Are we gonna enter playoffs? So I know there's playoffs. I don't know if the playoffs are just for A1 or for every division, because it's my intention to race A2 next season. Which wouldn't really make sense. But I was talking to, you know, Aaron with Super Duper Missile. And he says because they won, they got bumped up. But I don't know how that works, if some of them are B. I don't know either. Mitch, what's your watts per kilogram set at for Zwift power? Yeah, so it's just two races and we'll pop over. Yeah, no, I think if I we're doing a bunch of crits and stuff, it would be a 4-2 or a 4-2-5, you know? Endurance. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, well, this is, we got one more week of this. Spring is in the air, at least where I live. Yeah. When do you guys get like a month, huh? Yeah, probably hit 70 today, but in the mornings where I live, it's freezing. Oh, that's the time trial, that's the final race. Alright. Steve, you can hit some crits and just like perform terribly. Actually, I'm pretty sure you're allowed one A racer per race per season. Just sign up. Let's see what happens. Are you serious? Oh, you have a titanium femur too, right? Yeah. I have that too, but I equaled out. I'm surprised. You haven't. 70-30 is pretty extreme. I'm at like 52-48. You should do some outdoor rides I could do indoor rides where you just like tie your foot up and pedal. Training, yeah. Oh wow. Yeah, how long ago was this mission? It's crazy. Yeah, it's 6 years ago for me. Oh, did you have a compound fracture for it? Oh, yeah, I had that. I didn't have the pelvis, but what I did have was a spiral burst compound fracture where my bone exploded out of my leg. Yeah, traction, yep, pneumatoma. Oh boy. How many days in the ICU? Yeah, yours sounds a little worse than mine. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Did you have an instant trauma response where you didn't feel pain? Yeah. You were. Oh man, no, I've never been hit by a car like that. My accident was driver's seat. That's gnarly. Is that scarring? I mean, is it? No. I mean, like, mentally, are you scared to be outside? On the road? Yeah. Yeah, how long was the drive to the hospital? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, they took me to some, like, dumpy hospital and then flew me to Stanford. No, this is when I crashed. I drove my car off a freeway, you know, like those Clover freeway on-ramps where they're like 80 feet up. I just drove it right off. I don't do this anymore, but I had taken an Ambien the night before and was sleep driving at six in the morning. Yeah. And it was scary. All I remember is the 4 seconds breaking through the divider. And seeing the ground come in. And just being like, what in the, how in the hell did I get here? for you, man. It took me like 3.5 years to convince myself I wasn't in pain. Because I'm not at all. But yeah, I hear you on that, but not like, you know, like I don't want to be on painkillers, you know. Yeah. So well, I broke my back a couple times during COVID season on descent. And they wanted to give me like Dilaudid and fentanyl, and I'm like, guys, listen to me, like I have an extremely high pain threshold. Just give me Tylenol and codeine. I'll be okay. They're like, no. I'm like, yes, I don't want any of that shit. Like I can take it. Just don't worry about it. Yeah. Oh no, man. And it becomes priority number one, takes over your life. And shit. You're not productive. I don't even know if we're doing rooftop. Is this your first ride of the day, guys? Yeah. This one. I'm gonna jump up. I'm gonna jump off at 50 minutes. Is this your first? You guys are off right now? Okay. Good talking with you. Thanks for joining me. Thanks, Steve. I'll see you, Mitch. See ya. Participation trophy.
ride an hour. How about that?
Thank you.
too snowy. The clouds in the sky. Let's get to the summit. Got 2.5 minutes.
She reminds me.
for me. Come back tomorrow. 4:30. Zero number 5. Best race of the season. See you then.